I've just stopped on the way to Sligo, just outside my local village of Kiju, and I've stopped here by Kilronan Abbey because I want to show you, just share with you, this beautiful place which is so near to Beltinmer Cottage. And it's the place where O'Carolan, who was the last of the great Irish bards, is buried. So we'll just go in and this again is just a try out of my new technology. It's very exciting to be able to stop just so casually at a particular spot and just take my phone out and make a video. So I'll keep it fairly short just to begin with. I'm just walking up the hill here. And I know Carolyn's grave is here. I think it may be up there at the back. But I'll take you to see that on another day. What I want to show you just briefly, a bit slippy slidey, is the abbey. So this is the old abbey, Kilronan Abbey, and Kilronan Abbey would have been a part of what happened to all the old church buildings back in the reign of Henry VIII. This would have been a functioning abbey then. There would have been monks or friars here, and what happened during that time, of course, is referred to as the dissolution of the monasteries. The dissolution of the monasteries was about closing down all the monasteries. So all the roofs were taken off and the religious folk were dispersed. And all the land that had belonged to the religious orders was taken over then by Henry VIII and the English crown. So this abbey has certainly remained quite sturdy against all the weather and all the centuries since, because we're talking about 400 years ago or thereabouts. Well, actually 500 years ago or thereabouts. So this is the doorway into the abbey, and it's beautiful on the other side. I'll just show you. There's some wonderful, wonderful masonry here. Very skilled stonemason would have carved this. It's beautiful. And of course the view from the door of the abbey, you can just see it there, across Loch Mila, over across towards Kilmactranny Wood, and in Kilmactranny Woods you have a megalithic burial site, and on the loch itself you have lots of crannogs, and the crannog, which is spelled C-R-A-N-N-O-G, is a man-made island. and made by the ancient peoples as a way of being able to stay safe, either safe from attack or safe from the perils of living in what was then an extensively forested country. So there would have been lots of wild animals. So it's an absolutely beautiful spot, as I'm sure you'll agree. And even some of the contemporary monuments to the dead are in fact quite exquisite. Beautifully carved. I mean, look at this one here. Absolutely lovely. As with all Irish graveyards, it's kept in very good order. People in Ireland are very much into honouring their dead, and so at least once a year there is a meeting of families here in this cemetery, in this graveyard, and the graves are all cleaned, and you know, things are kept in good order. But there you can see the gable wall of the abbey, and you can see the wonderful view from here. So we're looking now into the west, we're looking towards Sligo and the beautiful mountain range, where you have Knocknarea, where Queen Maeve is buried, where you have Benbulbin, where the famous poet William Butler Yeats is buried in a cemetery very nearby, just under Benbulbin, as it's called. And it's just a beautiful, beautiful place. So, I hope you enjoyed that. And I hope that this is the beginning of many videos using this clever little camera and phone.